My name is Hannah Berg. I'm from Rapid City, South Dakota, and I went to St. Paul's Lutheran School in Rapid City. Today we're going to be reading from Genesis 22, verses 11 through 12, and our devotion is called "The Angel of the Lord Tested Abraham." But the angel of the Lord called out to him from heaven, "Abraham, Abraham." "Here I am," he replied. "Do not lay a hand on the boy," he said. "Do not do anything to him. Now I know that you fear God, because you have not withheld from me your son, your only son." Sometimes when the Bible speaks of an angel of the Lord or the angel of the Lord, it refers to mere angels, creatures of God who serve as God's messengers. However, other times we understand that the term angel of the Lord to refer not to a creature, but to the eternal Son of God himself. This is one of those times. Here, the angel speaks as God himself. "You have not withheld from me your son." Ponder that for a moment. The Son of God, approximately 2 millennia before he took on human flesh as the Son of Man, speaks to his distant human ancestor, Abraham. He stops Abraham from killing his son Isaac and sacrificing him as a burnt offering to the Lord. The Lord had commanded this to test Abraham's faith. Earlier, God had promised to save this world of sinners through Isaac, Abraham's son. But now, he had commanded Abraham to sacrifice Isaac. It made no human sense. It went against every fatherly instinct. But in his heart, Abraham passed the test. He was going to sacrifice his son. The Lord saw Abraham's heart and stopped Abraham from carrying it out. "Now I know that you fear God," he explained, "because you have not withheld from me your son, your only son." How difficult it must have been for Abraham to even consider doing this to his only son. Doesn't this thought become even more poignant through Advent as we meditate on the coming of Jesus at Christmas? Think about it. This very angel of the Lord is the Son of God. He knew full well what would happen in the future. He, God's only son, would be born of a woman. He would become a human being, and he would be sacrificed. He would die in our place to save us from our sins. God the Father would not withhold from us his son, his only son. God so loved the world. And we pray. Dear Father in heaven, whenever I am tempted to test you and demand proof of your love for me, graciously remind me that you did not spare your own son, but you gave him up for us all. I need no further proof. Amen. God's blessing on your Advent this year. Merry Christmas.